Welcome to Record Access via Sharing Rules, part of the Who Sees What series. These videos provide the basics on visibility and data access in Salesforce. In this video, we'll implement sharing rules to open record access up to users when the org-wide defaults are more restrictive than public read-write. At AW Computing, we set the org-wide sharing settings on opportunities to private, so only the person who owns the record can see it. We then created a role hierarchy to open up access to certain roles. Now sales ops can see the opportunities of all users below them in the hierarchy, and the US sales managers can see the opportunities of users in the US sales rep role. AW has grown and has added another sales team for the Asia Pacific region. Sales ops still sees all opportunities, US sales managers see their team's opportunities, and APEC managers see their team's opportunities. So the role hierarchy allowed us to open record access up vertically. However, we need a way to extend record access horizontally so that the US sales manager role can see records owned by the users in the APEC roles, and the APEC managers can see records owned by users in the US roles. Sharing rules let us extend access to users in roles, public groups, or territories, regardless of their place in the role hierarchy. Let's go to our practice org to see how this works. Let's set up sharing rules so that opportunities are visible to the people that need to see them. Sharing rules are in the same place as our org-wide defaults. Under Security Controls, Sharing Settings. We'll scroll down to the Opportunity Sharing Rules section and click New. We'll give our rule a label and a unique name will auto-populate. This rule will be based on record ownership. We'll share opportunities owned by the US sales manager and subordinates with the APAC sales manager role, and give the sales manager read-only access to opportunities owned by the US team. We'll create a second rule that shares the APAC records with the US manager. This will also be based on record ownership. We'll share the records owned by the APAC sales manager and their subordinates with the US sales manager, and we'll give read-only access. Now the sales managers can see the opportunities in each region. So we've just seen sharing rules based on record ownership. Let's take a look at a rule based on record criteria. We want the finance team to have visibility into any opportunities that the sales team has won. This rule will be based on record criteria, where the won field equals true. Any record that matches this criteria will be shared with the finance director and subordinates with read-only access. Nice. Even though our org-wide defaults for opportunities are private, we've given access to the teams that do need visibility by creating sharing rules. Here's a useful diagram to help you assess how the layers of visibility and access work. A user's baseline permissions on each object are determined by the profile. If you're using permission sets, these also set the baseline permissions in conjunction with the profile. Record access to records a user does not own are set first by the org-wide defaults. If your defaults are more restrictive than public read-write, you can open access back up to certain roles using the role hierarchy. You can further open up access using sharing rules. Sharing rules open up access horizontally or vertically to roles, groups, or territories. In addition, the record owner can also share individual records with other users by using the sharing button on the record. For more information on the topic of visibility and access, watch all of the titles in this video series. In addition, you can search for these topics in the Help and Training portal. Thanks for using Salesforce.